Welcome to the DCC Museum.
Hi, and welcome back at the museum. A new DCC enthusiast in the United States asked us to do something special to service a new inboxed DCC 900. We don't come across these often, so this is a perfect time to share an unboxing video with you like it was 1992. This brochure is a slightly different version of the first 100 brochure we have seen in European models. As this DCC 900 is a 1992 model, the brochure still shows the DCC 180 portable prototype that never went into production. The USA models always have two different serial numbers. The original from the plant starts with MZ for Marantz, in this case 07, which is revision 7, year 1992, and production week 51. We have not been able to determine why the extra serial number was required in the United States only. Since we have done several restoration videos on first generation DCC models, we will only show you the highlights in this one. We have often explained that no first-generation DCC player should be plugged in before replacing the 17 SMD capacitors on the read-write board and audio board, because of the potential damage it could cause to the read-write amplifier and or head. In this never-used player, one of the capacitors was floating around in the player. It proves the point that SMD capacitors will leak and can cause damage even if you have never once used the player. Removing the old capacitors, that are now also glued to the boards because the leaking acid acts like glue, can be best removed by hot air. Then the boards need to be manually cleaned and preferably also put in an ultrasonic bath to remove all remaining residue. We prefer using new SMD capacitors to keep it as close to original as possible. Naturally, belts and pinch rollers are also checked and replaced. This DCC-900 is on its way back to a new DCC enthusiast. Hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time.